Today we're going to be durability testing the new aluminum iPhone 15 and the iPhone 15 Plus. We already know the iPhone 15 Pro Max didn't survive. May it rest in pieces. I get a lot of questions of how I prepare for events like this and how I get enough nourishment for snapping phones in half. Well, huge thanks to Huel for sponsoring this video. I lost about 15 pounds a year ago, and I've kept it off ever since thanks to counting calories. In just a few seconds, Huel Black makes eating healthy easy by being exactly 400 calories of nutritionally complete plant-based proteins, carbs, and 27 essential vitamins and minerals. The stuff humans need to survive. Whether I'm bending aluminum or titanium, I can't do it without my vitamins. And take a look at all of these good things. Personally, I like the cookies and cream. It's my absolute favorite. I haven't come across one I haven't liked yet. I take that back. Salted caramel is not on my favorites list, but luckily there's 8 other flavors to choose from, and the important thing is that they don't have artificial sweeteners. You don't have to take my word for it though. Huel has sold over 300 million meals in over 100 million countries. Whoa, that's a lot of countries. Let me start again. Huel has sold over 300 million meals in 100 different countries, and you get a free t-shirt with your order. As a special bonus, if you spend over $100 and use my code JerryRigEverything15, you will get $15 off your order, but only for the next 72 hours. Link is down in the description if you want to try it out for yourself. And now that we're fueled, let's get started. One super easy way to tell if your iPhone is real or genuine, and not a sneakily sealed up box with a brick in it, is with a sweet little hologram thing that Apple added to the sticker of each box. 100% invisible to the naked eye, you'll have to have a UV flashlight to see it, which aren't too expensive. Or, you know, just buy your phone from somewhere or someone reputable. This is my first time seeing the new aluminum iPhone 15 lineup, and I gotta say, these aren't so much colors as they are just different shades of white. Apple says this is green, but I say it's what we'd get after putting 5 potatoes and a green bean in a blender. Got a braided USB-C cable though, which is nice. Thank you. This is either what smartphones are gonna look like in heaven, or the first blade of grass you see after getting hit with a flashbang. Jokes aside, the iPhone 15 does feel incredibly good. I can't quite describe it, but holding it in my hand gives me the same wow vibes that I got for the first time holding an iPhone 4, way back in the day. The super flat glass leading right up to the contoured aluminum frame. I genuinely approve of these design tweaks. Almost scratched it. That'd be embarrassing. Plus, the USB-C port is just bringing the whole world together and is perfect. I'm being far too clumsy today, I apologize. We better move on before something happens to this phone. Oh yeah, I am that something. Apple has their own proprietary glass called Ceramic Shield. We see plastic scratch at a level 2 or 3, glass at a 5 or 6, and sapphire at a level 8 or 9. And after working our way up through most scale of hardness on this iPhone 15, I just can't say it this time. If I squint my eyes and really struggle, I can make out some tiny marks at level 6, and scratches at a level 7, which I know doesn't quite have the same ring to it, but, I mean, you can see for yourself, Apple's glass is definitely more scratch-resistant than Android glass. Ceramic Shield, with all of its crystal-infused buzzwords, is actually an improvement over regular tempered glass. So, thumbs up for that. The 12-megapixel front-facing camera is tucked up into the massive dynamic island, which technically we can make fun of all day long, but at the same time, the Apple engineers have worked some pretty awesome features into this thing, like the airline gate. I'm over here on my Android phone checking my email 5 times as I walk down the terminal because I have the memory of a goldfish, and Apple just has it displayed. I'm just saying, I'm a little jealous, but only sometimes. It looks like Apple again added the invincible 5G adamantium antenna oval, and the rest of the anodized aluminum scratches pretty easy, including the power button. Apple doesn't specify which series of aluminum they're using this time around. It could be 6 or 7,000 series. I'll see if I can get it fluorescently scanned with x-rays and find out here in another video soon. So make sure you're subscribed for that. The USB-C port is USB 2, which is just as fast at transferring data as the previous Lightning port. This phone is colored like a 4-year-old who ran out of food dye during an Easter egg contest. I do really like the feel of the matte finish though. Apple tried to tell us that there are 3 cameras up here during their event, but any 4-year-old without food coloring could easily tell us there are only 2. The lower is a 48-megapixel main camera lens. Apple says the sensor is big enough for a 4x crop, turning the main lens into an optical telephoto. But if you're only using a fraction of the sensor, is it still considered optical? Personally, I'd say no. There's a 12-megapixel wide-angle camera up top, which I guess, according to Apple's math, is a 12x optical if you crop to 1 megapixel. One of the Apple designers probably mowed his lawn and then walked across marble tile and was like, that's the color of the next iPhone. On the front of the phone, we have 6.1 inches worth of 2000 nits, Super Retina, XDR, HDR, and as we can tell by the white dot burning into the screen, OLED. I would have gone longer, but the app started quivering, and I am merciful. Sometimes. Finally, the ultimate test of structure and rigidity, that most phones do survive, the bin test. For some reason, the iPhone 15 Pro Max just didn't make it. We'll start with the same position as we did with the Pro Max, with pressure from the back, and nothing. We're off to a good start, or a bad start depending on what you're here for. The screen kinda stopped working for a bit, which is strange, but after a quick flick on and off, it came back to life. Continuing the bin from the front, again nothing. This sunbleached skittle of a phone survives the bin test. Enter the iPhone 15 Plus with Essence of Blue. It wasn't the smaller of the Pro phones that broke, it was the larger. So it's only fair that we also bin test the larger 15 Plus as well, which has the exact same features as the 15. There are quite a few reasons why a phone could break. Microscopic imperfections in the materials, flaws in casting or milling. Consistent manufacturing is extremely difficult, especially with so many different puzzle pieces that have to fit together precisely. And just because one phone breaks doesn't necessarily mean that they all will. I mean, they might, but they also might not. Lucky for Apple and this freezer-burned iPhone 15 Plus, no amount of bending from the back or the front causes any damage. That means 3 of the 4 new iPhones from Apple survive my durability test. Thanks for subscribing, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.